Judah, from which Jesus was descended. And there was also another tribe, the rest of all the tribes, living separately. And as you remember, Moses had given the Israelites a lot of laws. The most famous of them were, of course, 10. And one of those was, you shall worship no god but me. And the Israelites had gone off the track a bit, and they were worshipping all sorts of weird things. You know, in the story of Moses and Aaron, they made a carved figure of an animal and stuck gold leaf over it and started worshipping that. That angered Moses. So by now, they've got quite a well-organized system of priests, and they were worshipping a god called Baal. And Elijah, who was one of the few remaining prophets of God, didn't like this at all. He kept reminding the people of how evil they were. There was only one other man left who was called Obadiah. That's a nice name for you. And he was sent by Elijah to tell King Ahab that he would at last agree to meet him, because Ahab and his rather wicked wife, Jezebel, was haunting Elijah because they kept pricking their conscience about the things they shouldn't be doing. Anyway, Elijah met Ahab, and he said, oh, I found you at last, I need a troublemaker, said Ahab. What, me? Said Elijah. I'm not the troublemaker. You are, and your delightful wife, Jezebel. All the dreadful things that you've been doing. I tell you what, he said, there seems to be a bit of a contest going on here as to which god is the greatest. So what we'll do is this. You meet me on Mount Carmel, and bring your 400 prophets of Baal, and your 450 prophets of Asherah, who was a goddess that Jezebel's lot worshipped, and I'll bring a few Israelites along with me, and just me, as a prophet, and we'll see what happens. So he said, right, here we are, we'll meet you on top of Mount Carmel. And he said, right up, take a ball. There's a ball. Mine's a bit small, because Mount Carmel is small. You see that on the front row. Wonderful ball out, straight from the Lord's shop. And he said, look, cut your ball up into 400 bits and pieces, one for each barmy prophet, and stick it on an altar, but don't set it on fire. So they did that. And they said, he said, right, so now he said, ask your God to consume, burn up this sacrifice. So the prophets of Baal are going, oh great God, come burn our bulls. And what happened? Not a lot. So they bounced around, your God's asleep, so they've got a prancing around, cutting themselves with knives, doing all sorts of dreadful things. The blood was running everywhere. The bull's at the end. And he said, come on. He said, perhaps your God's gone to the loo. Well, he didn't have loos in those days, but he said, relieve himself from behind the tree of the spring. And he was taking the mickey. And nothing at all happened. So Elijah said, right, that'll do. And he said to all the Israelites, come here. Huh? No, not by that chap on his own. But he said, gather in. And he did this. He built an altar of 12 stones, because there were 12 tribes of Israel. There was one for Issachar, one for, forgot his name, one for Zebulun, one for Joseph, one for Simeon, what's that? Oh yes, one for Reuben, one for Asher, one for Levi, one for Benjamin, one for Gad, one for Daniel, and one for Judah. There we are. And he said, right, I'm going to put on top of there the base for the sacrifice. And he said, I'm going to put on now some fuel. Now, I must have been on cheating busy, because I'm not Elijah and I'm not as purple as eagles. But you see how we get on. Anyway, right, put fuel. And he said, now, what I want you to do, he said, is soak that all over with water. He said, pour gallons of water on it. Dig a trench around it and fill that up with water as well. So, we put a little water on. Here we go. Let's put a little water on. There are wonderful stones. There we go. There goes the water. Beautiful. I'll just soak it around a little bit. See? There we go. Let's mix in the water nicely. Oh, that's wonderful. And he said, right up. Beautiful. Put some more water on it. So they came along and they put some more water on it. And he said, now, put the bull on quick. And I put the ball on quick, and he said, I'm going to